The Netherlands' prime minister apologizes on behalf of the Dutch state for its historical role in slavery. Mark Rutte made the apology Monday in a televised speech at the Dutch National Archives. He admits for centuries the Dutch state and its representatives enabled slavery and profited from it. Rutte adds the Netherlands bears responsibility for the immense suffering done to those that were enslaved and their descendants. Rutte was responding to a national advisory panel set up following the 2020 killing of George Floyd in the United States. The panel says Dutch participation in slavery had amounted to crimes against humanity. Last year, it recommended that the Dutch state issue an apology and make reparations. The first banknotes bearing the image of Britain's King Charles III are set to enter circulation by mid-2024. That's according to the Bank of England, which unveiled the designs to the media on Tuesday. The king's image will appear on the front of the banknotes, as well as in cameo in the see-through security window. The bank adds the design was approved by the king, and the notes will be mass-produced by the first half of 2023. But current polymer banknotes carrying the late Queen Elizabeth II's portrait will remain legal tender. This means that from mid-2024 onwards, notes featuring both monarchs will co-circulate. Russian President Vladimir Putin denies Moscow's plans to absorb Belarus to help its invasion of Ukraine. He made the remarks Tuesday as he met with the Belarusian leader Alexander Lukashenko in Minsk. Putin's visit to the former Soviet country came as Russia launched fresh attacks on Ukraine, targeting its critical infrastructure. The USA Department calls Putin's supposed reassurance as ironic, given its ongoing war in Ukraine. Ned Price adds Washington will impose more sanctions against Belarus if it continues to aid the Kremlin's assault on Kyiv. U.S. President Joe Biden denounces anti-Semitism to mark the Jewish Festival of Lights, or the Hanukkah. Speaking at the White House ceremony Monday, Biden urged Americans to combat anti-Semitism, saying all forms of hate and violence have no place in America. Biden adds keeping silent on the hate crimes is complicity. A racism watchdog has recorded the largest number of anti-Semitic incidents in the U.S. last year, including murder and physical assault on the Jewish community. Hollywood movie producer Harvey Weinstein is found guilty of rape and two other counts of sexual assault by a Los Angeles jury Monday. This is Weinstein's second conviction after being convicted of sex crimes in New York back in 2020. He already faces up to 18 years in jail for his previous cases, but that could potentially reach 24 years due to aggravating factors. Allegations against Weinstein have helped fuel the Me Too movement, where women have spoken out against sexual abuse by influential men in various fields. American actress Amber Heard agrees to settle her defamation case with her ex-husband Johnny Depp. Heard took to Instagram Monday to describe her move as a very difficult decision. She maintains the settlement is not an act of concession, but a choice made out of losing faith in the American legal system. Depp sued Heard over a 2018 op-ed in which she alleged abuse during their two-year marriage. Depp's lawyer said Heard will pay $1 million US dollars for the settlement of the case.